Members of Parliament from the sub-regions of Lango, Acholi and West Nile today received 27 high-capacity tractor units plus 326 walk-behind tractors to spark commercial farming in their areas. They received the consignment at Namalere National Mechanization Referral Center in Wakiso District from the Ministry of Agriculture in fulfillment of the presidential pledge.
We grow maize, we grow beans, we grow cassava, we grow coffee, we grow very many things that we eat as food crop, but we sell it now, which has become cash crop. But people in West Nile and Lango and Acholi have been doing this in smaller scale and with the rudimentary tools like hoes.
We've been given one tractor today. We received about two other tractors a while back. So we have three tractors out of 11 sub-counties.
Legislators noted that the sub-regions were lagging behind economically due to absence of such initiatives from the government towards boosting agricultural productivity.
In Uganda, Acholi sub-region, we have the vast chunk of land that is underutilized because we don't have these equipments. So we want to thank the President and Ministry of Agriculture for really rolling out this program to us in a transparent way.
They are not yet enough. More should be given. Acholi sub-region has a lot of land which is lying idle because the people don't have the capacity to open this land.
The government chief whip, Dennis Hamson Oboa, revealed that these tractors are fruits of this year's Chankwanzi retreat of the NRM Parliamentary Caucus, where legislators from the three sub-regions convinced the president on the necessity of supporting mechanization of agriculture in northern Uganda.
Any doubting Thomases have always asked, can anything good come out of the National Resistance Movement Parliamentary Caucus when we retreat at the National Leadership Institute? Of all the many things, one of the answers is also here today.
The Minister for Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, Frank Tumwebaze, noted that the initiative is tailored at complementing the parish development model that is benefiting smallholder farmers.
To open up the big chunks of land, the contribution of the smallholder farmers alone is not enough, isn't it? Just look at coffee alone. We export 8.4 bags, 8.4 million, 60 kilogram.
Norbert Mao, the Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, urged the people of northern Uganda to take advantage of the vacating the nomadic pastoralists, commonly known as Balalo, and use these machines to venture into commercial farming on the land that is currently vast. Mao believes the three sub-regions still deserve more from the government to be able to catch up with other regions that developed while the north was being ravaged by a series of insurgents. He emphasized the need for the Balalo to leave northern Uganda, saying that they are not fair to the local communities.
Our people are extremely vulnerable. You come with money, buy 50 acres, then you bring 200 cows. Then you are actually colonizing 300 acres in the neighborhood because nobody has ability to cultivate.
Government has spent 3.24 billion shillings on these tractors and 8.5 billion shillings on the 326 walk-behind tractors. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.